Hi, scholars. I'm Miss Liss from Monte Vista South Athenaeum. I hope you are all having a wonderful and safe time at home. I have been trying really hard to stick to a routine or schedule so I don't get too bored, and I make sure that I still get some work and learning done during the day. One of the things that has really helped me with this, believe it or not, is baking. My family and I have always really enjoyed baking, but we don't always have enough time to do it. Now that we've been at home for so long, we have more time than ever, and we have had the chance to do a little bit of experimenting with our baking. I have baked more cakes and cupcakes than I could possibly count, but one thing that I have never tried to bake is bread. Bread is often considered complicated to bake because it relies on yeast to rise. Yeast is a single-celled organism that is a member of the fungi kingdom. The yeast we use today is one of the oldest domesticated organisms known to man, and it is just one of more than 1,500 strands of yeast. Yeast feeds on sugar. Yeast can convert flour into sugar, then eat the sugar and produce carbon dioxide, a kind of gas, which allows the bread to rise. A certain kind of bread, called sourdough, requires something called a starter. A starter is a mixture of flour and water that has been allowed to rest, which allows yeast and good bacteria to grow naturally. However, you don't just mix the flour and water and leave it. Most sourdough starters have to be fed every 12 to 24 hours. What do you think it means to feed the starter? To feed the starter, I have to add flour and water to it to give the developed yeast something to eat, so it can continue to grow and mature. Every day after I eat lunch or dinner, I feed my starter, then let it rest overnight until the same time the next day. When it rests, it often doubles or even triples in size. This is a sign of a healthy starter. Today, I am going to show you how I feed my starter. First, I make sure that I have 12 grams of developed starter in a glass jar. When baking, I like to use grams instead of tablespoons because it is very important to be accurate in your work. Then I measure out 25 grams of rye flour and add it to my starter. Then I measure 25 grams of all-purpose flour and add it to my starter. Finally, I add 50 grams of water to the starter. Then I mix it all together, making sure that there is no dry flour remaining. Then I put a loose lid on top of the jar and I let it sit overnight. You want to cover it loosely so that the starter has room to grow and air can escape easily. Why does the air need to be able to escape? The air needs to be able to escape so the jar doesn't get too much pressure inside. If the jar were to get too much pressure inside, it could explode. Feeding my sourdough starter has become a part of my nightly routine that I really enjoy. By creating a routine that includes work and some things that I really enjoy, like baking, I have been able to make the most of my time at home. Scholars, thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit more about what I've been doing with my time and about how bread works. Have a great day.